Daily Morning Prayer, Tuesday, April 2nd, 2024. If then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Let us humbly confess our sins, Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no hope in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord, and grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may not only be godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a clean mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouths shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. Alleluia. Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast, not with the old leaven, the leaven of malice and evil, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Alleluia. Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death that he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. So also consider yourselves dead to sin, and alive to God in Christ Jesus our Lord. Alleluia. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since by a man came death, by a man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, so also in Christ shall all be made alive. Alleluia. I will give thanks unto you, O Lord, with my whole heart. I will speak of all your marvelous works. I will be glad and rejoice in you. Indeed, my songs will I sing of your name, O Most High. When my enemies are driven back, they shall fall and perish at your presence. For you have maintained my right and my cause. You sit on your throne, judging right. You have rebuked the nations and destroyed the ungodly. You have blotted out your name forever and ever. As for the enemy, their destruction has come. They are in perpetual ruin. Like the cities which you have destroyed, their memory has perished with them. But the Lord sits enthroned forever. He has prepared his seat for judgment. For he shall judge the world in righteousness and minister true judgment to the peoples. The Lord will be a defense for the oppressed, even a refuge in the time of trouble. And those who know your name will put their trust in you. For you, Lord, have never failed those who seek you. O praise the Lord who dwells in Zion. Tell the peoples what things he has done. For when he takes vengeance for blood, he remembers them and forgets not the cry of the poor. Have mercy upon me, O Lord. Consider the trouble I suffer for from those who hate me. O you who lift me up from the gates of death, I may tell of all your praises within the gates of the city of Zion. I will rejoice in your salvation. The nations have sunk down in the pit that they made, in the same net which they hid secretly is their foot caught. The Lord is known to execute judgment. The ungodly are trapped in the works of their own hands. The wicked shall return to the grave, even all the peoples that forget God. For the poor shall not always be forgotten. The patient hope of the meek shall not perish forever. Rise up, O Lord, and let them not have the upper hand. Let the nations be judged in your sight. Put them in fear, O Lord, that the nations may know themselves to be merely human. Why do you stand so far off, O Lord, and hide your face in a time of need and trouble? The ungodly, in his pride, persecutes the poor. Let him be taken in the crafty schemes that he has imagined. For the ungodly has boasted of his own heart's desire. The covetous holds the Lord contempt and blasphemes his name. The ungodly is so proud that he cares not for God, neither is God in any of his thoughts. His ways are always grievous. Your judgments are far above, out of his sight, and therefore he defies all his enemies. For he has said in his heart, I shall never be cast down. No harm shall happen to me. His mouth is full of cursing, deceit, and fraud. Under his tongue are ungodliness and vanity. He sits lurking in the thievish corners of the streets, and in his hiding places he murders the innocent. His eyes are set against the poor, for he lies waiting secretly, even as a lion lurks in his den, that he may ravish the poor. He ravishes the poor when he gets him into his net. The innocent is crushed and humbled before him, and the weak cannot stand against his might. He has said in his heart, God has forgotten. He hides away his face, that he will never see it. Arise, O Lord God, and lift up your hand. Forget not the poor. Why should the wicked blaspheme God while he says in his heart, you, O God, do not care? Surely you have seen it, for you behold ungodliness, that you may take the matter in your hand. The poor commits himself unto you, for you are the helper of the fatherless. Break the power of the ungodly and malicious. Search out his ungodliness until you have brought it all to light. The Lord is king forever and ever, and the nations have perished out of the land. O Lord, you have heard the desire of the poor. You prepare their heart, and your ear hearkens to it, to help the fatherless and poor with justice, that the one who is of the earth may terrify no more. To help the fatherless and poor with justice, that the one who is of the earth may terrify no more. In the Lord I put my trust. How then can you say to my soul, flee as a bird unto the hill? For behold, the ungodly bend their bow and make ready their arrow upon the string, that they may secretly shoot at those who are true of heart. For the foundations will be cast down, and what can the righteous do? The Lord is in his holy temple. The Lord's throne is in heaven. His eyes consider the poor, and his eyelids try the children of men. The Lord tests the righteous, but the ungodly and those who delight in wickedness, his soul abhors. Upon the ungodly, he shall rain snares, fire and brimstone, storm and tempest. This shall be their portion to bring. This shall be their portion to drink. For the righteous Lord loves righteousness. The upright shall behold his face. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Exodus, beginning with the 40th chapter, the first verse. Then the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, on the first day of the first month, you shall set up the tabernacle of the tent of meeting. You shall place the ark of the testimony there, and you shall screen off the ark with the veil. Then you shall bring in the table and arrange what belongs on it. And you shall bring in the lampstand above its lamps. You shall also set the gold altar of incense in front of the ark of the testimony, and set up the curtain for the doorway to the tabernacle. And you shall set the altar of burnt offering in front of the doorway of the tabernacle of the tent of meeting. Then you shall set the basin between the tent of meeting and the altar, and put water in it. You shall also set up the courtyard all around, and hang up the curtain of the gate of the courtyard. Then you shall take the anointing oil, and anoint the tabernacle and everything that is in it, and consecrate it and all its furnishings, and it shall be holy. You shall also anoint the altar of burnt offering and all its utensils and consecrate the altar, and the altar shall be most holy. You shall anoint the basin and its stand and consecrate it. Then you shall bring Aaron and his sons and the doorway of the tent of meeting and wash them in water. And you shall put the holy garments on Aaron and anoint him and consecrate him so that he may serve as a priest to me. You shall also bring his sons and put tunics on them. You shall anoint them just as you have anointed their father so that they may serve as priests to me. And their anointing will qualify them for a permanent priesthood throughout their generations. So Moses did these things according to all that the Lord had commanded him. So he did. Now in the first month of the second year, on the first day of the month, the tabernacle was erected. Moses erected the tabernacle and laid its bases and set up its boards and inserted its bars and erected its pillars. And he spread the tent over the tabernacle and put the covering of the tent on top of it, just as the Lord had commanded Moses. Then he took the testimony and put it into the ark and attached the poles to the ark and put the atoning cover on top of the ark. Then he brought the ark into the tabernacle and set up a veil for the covering and screened out the ark of the testimony, just as the Lord had commanded Moses. He also put the ark in the tent of meeting on the north side of the tabernacle outside the veil, and he set the arrangement of bread on it before the Lord, just as the Lord had commanded Moses. And he placed the lampstand in the tent of meeting opposite the table on the south side of the tabernacle. And he lighted the lamps before the Lord, just as the Lord had commanded Moses. Then he placed the golden altar in the tent of meeting in front of the veil, and he burnt fragrant incense on it, just as the Lord had commanded Moses. And he set up the curtain for the doorway of the tabernacle, and he set the altar of burnt offering in front of the doorway of the tabernacle of the tent of meeting and offered on it the burnt offering and the meal offering, just as the Lord had commanded Moses. He placed the basin between the tent of meeting and the altar and put water in it for washing. From it, Moses and Aaron and his sons washed their hands and their feet. When they entered the tent of meeting and when they approached the altar, they washed, just as the Lord had commanded Moses. And he erected the courtyard all around the tabernacle and the altar and hung up the curtain for the gate of the courtyard. So Moses finished the work. Then the cloud covered the tent of meeting, and the glory of the Lord filled the tabernacle. And Moses was not able to enter the tent of meeting because of the cloud, because the cloud had settled on it, and the glory of the Lord filled the tabernacle. Throughout their journeys, whenever the cloud was taken up from over the tabernacle, the sons of Israel would set out, but if the cloud was not taken up, then they would not set out until the day when it was taken up. For throughout their journeys, the cloud of the Lord was on the tabernacle by day, and there was fire in it by night, in the sight of all the house of Israel. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory to you, Lord God of the fathers, you are glory, you are worthy of praise. Glory to you for the radiance of your holy name. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. Glory to you in the splendor of your temple, and the throne of your majesty. Glory to you. Glory to you seated between the cherubim. Praise you and highly exalt you forever. Glory to you, beholding the depths in the high vault of heaven. Glory to you. Glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. A reading from the Gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark, beginning with the second chapter of the first verse. When Jesus came back to Capernaum a few days later, it was heard that he was at home, and many were gathered together so that there was no longer space, not even near the door, and he was speaking the word to them. And some people came bringing to him a man who was paralyzed, carried by four men. And when they were unable to get to him because of the crowd, they removed the roof above him, and after digging an opening, they let down the pallet on which the paralyzed man was lying. And Jesus, seeing their faith, said to the paralyzed man, "Son, your sins are forgiven." But some of the scribes were sitting there and thinking it over in their hearts, "Why does this man speak that way? He is blaspheming. Who can forgive sins except God alone?" Immediately, Jesus, aware in his spirit that they were thinking that they were thinking that way within themselves, said to them, "Why are you thinking about these things in your hearts? Which is easier, to say to the paralyzed man, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Get up, pick up your pallet, and walk'? But so that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins." He said to the paralyzed man, "I say to you, pick up. I said to you, get up, pick up your pallet, and go home." And he got up and immediately picked up the pallet and went out in the sight of everyone, so that they were all amazed and were glorifying God, saying, "We have never seen anything like this." And he went out again by the seashore, and all the people were coming to him, and he was teaching them. As he passed by, he saw Levi, the son of Alphaeus, sitting at the tax office, and he said to him, "Follow me." And he got up and followed him. And it happened that he was reclining at the table in his house, and many tax collectors and sinners were dining with Jesus and his disciples, for there were many of them, and they were following him. When the scribes of the Pharisees saw that he was sitting with the sinners and tax collectors, they said to his disciples, "Why is he eating with tax collectors and sinners?" And hearing this, Jesus said to them, "It is not those who are healthy who need a physician, but those who are sick. I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners." John's disciples and the Pharisees were fasting, and they came and said to him, "Why do John's disciples and the disciples of the Pharisees fast, but your disciples do not fast?" And Jesus said to them, "While the groom is with them, the attendants of the groom cannot fast, can they? As long as they have the groom with them, they cannot fast. But the days will come when the groom is taken away from them, and then they will fast on that day. No one sews a patch of unshrunk cloth on an old garment, otherwise the patch pulls away from it, the old from the new, and the worst tear results. And no one puts new wine into old wine skins, otherwise the wine will burst the skins, for the wine is lost in the skins, the skin as well. But one puts new wine into fresh wine skins." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Splendor and honor and kingly power are yours by right, O Lord our God. For you created everything that is, and by your will they were created and have their being. And yours by right, O Lamb that was slain. For with your blood you have redeemed for God from every family, language, people, and nation, a kingdom, a priest to serve our God. And so to him who sits upon the throne, and to Christ the Lord, be worship and praise, dominion and splendor forever and forevermore. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Lord, show your mercy upon us and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Lord, your ministers with righteousness and let your people sin and joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. And not the needy or not be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. O God, who by the glorious resurrection of your Son Jesus Christ destroyed death and brought life and immortality to light, grant that we, who have been raised with him, may abide in his presence and rejoice in the hope of eternal glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. O God, the author of peace and lover of comfort, to know you is eternal life and to serve you is perfect freedom. Defend us, your humble servants, in all assaults and of our enemies, that we shall be trusting in your defense. May not fear the power of any adversaries through the might of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, who alone works great marvels, send down upon our clergy and the congregations committed to their charge the life-giving spirit of your grace. Shower them with the continual dew of your blessing and ignite in them as well as love of your gospel through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom we have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, he will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia. Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Lord, your God, his power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation, in the church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen.